Libby is located in the northwest corner of Montana. We're about 35 miles from Idaho and about 75 miles to Canada.
Libby was a pretty hustle and bustling community. There were quite a few jobs here.
A lot of logging, the lumber mill was very active, and then of course the vermiculite mining began in the 20s. At peak production in the mid-70s, 80% of the world's vermiculite came out of Libby's vermiculite mountain. The mine, they gave the product away free throughout the community. So people insulated their homes, put it in their gardens. The high school running track was made out of the ore. One of the processing facilities, or popping plants, was located right beside the local baseball field. So their waste piles would be these huge piles along the ball field. So when kids were playing ball, their siblings would play in the piles of vermiculite. So it was just an everyday, you know, part of community life in Libby.
Vermiculite was a flat-shaped crystal. It formed it like mica. And through geologic time, it ended up crystallizing as a fibers. And this fibrous rock was hard not to mine along with the vermiculite.
In 1999, there was a media expose. There was a health problems associated with the vermiculite. So EPA came to town, and it turned out that the vermiculite was identified with the asbestos contaminant, and that it was everywhere.
We developed CARD in the year 2000. Working with the local hospital, we decided to set up the clinic to follow people after they had their screening, to go over any abnormalities, and to diagnose those that had evidence of asbestos-related disease. When we got through the first 2 years, we had the federal government's screening program through ATSDR had screened 7,300 people. And over 18% of these individuals had evidence of asbestos-related findings. And a further study that they did using CT scan actually showed that it was much higher than that, that probably 25 to 27% of the population, or perhaps one in four, had evidence suggesting they were experiencing asbestos-related disease.
My parents built a new home in the 60s when I was in high school, and they put asbestos in the attic of that home for insulation. My bedroom was an attic bedroom.
The only thing I can think of is how I got it is my dad worked up a mine, and he worked the midnight shift, and I go up there and sat with him until I'd get tired, and then I'd go to sleep till he gets off work. And that's the only thing, the way I can figure I got it.
Lung disease created by significant exposure involves the lining around the lung, the pleura, most commonly the parietal pleura, which lays against the chest wall, and the muscle and rib of the chest wall. It progresses from a small area to where it becomes extensive. Radiologists are unfamiliar with the appearance of this type of fibrosis, so it's created a real problem in recognition. And one of the big symptoms that people have is chest pain. Chest pain is not common with asbestos-related diseases. The other thing is it's very common for individuals to experience airway disease. And they would be labeled as asthmatics, or if they had any cigarettes in their lives, would probably be called COPD. So why is this important? Well, this material, this ore, was exported to over 250 sites, closer to 300 perhaps, around North America. If they are developing problems, it could well be missed.
Asbestos-related diseases have at least a 10-year latency period. It's 10 to 40 years before the disease would show up.
That has been something that we continually try to address from our end, and being available to try to educate and outreach and help other people understand the differences and what to look for.
Over the past 16 years, the community has really evolved, and now it's to the point of no longer are we in the midst of a crisis. You know, we're transitioning to looking for a cure through research. CARD is also a place to go. You know, we didn't have a pulmonologist in town before, and so it's a resource to people, not only for healthcare, but, you know, daily living impacts, or how do I stay as healthy as possible? The emotional sides, we have two social workers on staff. And so CARD is really that ultimate resource, anything asbestos, health and life-wise, where people can go.
One of the things that CARD helped bring about was legislation for people of Libby and getting it so that people who were diagnosed would have long-term medical care. And they also get what is called a pilot program, which is a program that pays for things above and beyond what Medicare would normally pay for, like helping people to get their lawns mown and shovel their snow, chop their wood, clean their homes.
They've helped me out, I think. I probably wouldn't be here right now if it wasn't for the CARD claim. And I plan on being here for a few more years.